KK. Regardless, we're on King's Row. It is going to be reunited first on the defense. So it's going to be Unfixed is going to play that Pharah. Cruz, of course, will play Lucio. Winghaven on his steady old Reinhardt. Morte will very likely be coming up as a Mercy. It'll be interesting to see what Shades and Valataja play. Shades right now is on the Reaper, Valataja on the Roadhog. I'd switch that if I were them, but I think they're going to give Shades another chance on the Reaper.
I think that is what they'll be going with. I do think Valataja actually plays a really, really good Reaper to where maybe you put Valataja on the Reaper and put Shades on the Roadhog and it goes a little bit better based on what we've seen.
Yep, definitely. I would run that switch, but apparently, you know, they're still trialing, and if they want Shades to be running Reaper, they got to see him on it, so...
All right, meanwhile, take a look here at the offense coming out from the side of Misfits, a side that is going into the series with a 1-0 advantage. This is going to be Zebosai here in the Lucio, Zapri on McCree, Nevix on Mercy, Skipjack on Reinhardt, Crew on the Hanzo, and Soon come around things out here on the Reaper.
Okay, so I mean, just pretty standard defense, nothing super interesting or out of the realm. I mean, we've seen Roadhog so much on that defense. I really wonder if Crew's going to stick on this Hanzo. He's been playing a good Hanzo lately. It's a very damage-oriented offense here, that single tank. So they're putting a lot on Skipjack's shoulders, but they're going to have so much firepower behind it.
Absolutely will, and we'll see just how this works out. Skipjack will be leading the way. Crew's going to be here on the Hanzo, and offensive Hanzo definitely getting some value here today. Not in all maps, every now and then it's been sort of a waste, but that is Hanzo. He is Feast or Famine. And Crew can move in here and look for that on-point first pick. And as I say that, I take it back. He's going to swap out. Going to the Pharah instead.
Got to get that Sonic Arrow in.
He just wanted to make sure there was no Bastion, no craziness, no El Presidente in the back.
Skipjack taking a lot of damage. They got to get out here. I mean, they're eating so much damage. They got to back up at least a little bit. Zapri and Skipjack come back to get healed up. They're going to kind of wait on this push for their Pharah combo to come over the top.
The offense got poked down a lot there. It was good on them to be able to back up and not get immediately punished the way that they very likely could have. But the offense still moving forward, looking for the opportunity. They do want to get in before the defense gets big ults. Crew, though, in the back right now, going to find Unfix instead. Unfix with the first kill of the game, wins that fair v fair fight, piling on, gets the double kill. And even with the res coming up here, I'm not sure if this is greatest res given respawns. I think maybe they would have been better off holding off as the offense just able to get into the back line, or the defense able to get more into the back line, picking off even more Shades on the double kill. Shades making it a triple, in fact. And the defense just absolutely feasting right now, even after the resurrection.
Yeah, Soon's going to bleed out late too. Their offense is completely stymied right now. They need to wait for Soon. They're going to switch Nevix onto the Mercy here, just trying to get that charge going. They just need to wait. The sound barrier has to come off before they even think about taking the next fight.
Defense does have a lot of good ults to their name right now. And not only do they have Whole Hog, they have Barrage, they have Earth Shatter. Lots of way for them to win this fight. Here comes the offense on the sound barrier. Sound barrier coming up from both sides though. Whole Hog just pushing people back. And they're looking for the hammer down. Gonna get pushed back instead. Fix with the first kill. Crew with the Barrage gets absolutely nothing from it to start things out here. And look at Winghaven, he's in the back, he's going to go down. And the defense slowly getting wiped out here. Morte, though, big resurrection, bringing everyone back to the fight. And this might be Shades' moment to shine. Does have Death Blossom at the ready. Will he come into the fight? Will he press Q? Does press Q, but is immediately bopped by Soon.
Yeah, Soon is putting this team on his back right now. He's in there so many kills. Valataja goes down eventually to Zapri. Their damage really carried them in that fight. They're going to be able to take this point and didn't even have to use all the ultimates. They still have some really great stuff going. This combo is going to move super far forward, looking for even more chip. Oh my god, Crew took out Morte, who was just coming out of spawn.
Long range rocket doing all sorts of work there, and that's bad. They're going to have to wait for Morte to come back all the way from final. It's going to take a while for them to actually get back onto the point, and... here for the offensive Misfits, they're going to be able to move this all the way to the first bend relatively easily.
Yeah, I mean, they got a lot of damage, a lot of kills there early, but I mean, you're always kind of limited by how slow the cart moves. It's still not even around first point, so defense can possibly still defend in the first section of the streets. I mean, it's nice to get that kill, but it doesn't effectively do all that much except give you a little alt charge.
Right now for the offense, moving around the backside, looking for an opportunity. Getting counterpoked in turn as Valataja really coming in, taking out Zapri. Zapri also on McCree, so McCree versus McCree action taking place here in the streets phase. Both teams landing some good poke. Offense still with a bit of an ult advantage here going forward. They do have a Barrage, they have Earth Shatter, they have Deadeye even, so until they do here. Soon able to get in, takes out Valataja. And they're about to have Soundbear as well. Soon again getting so much value in the pub. Not a good place to be here with Soon. As Soon about to pick up the triple kill, elbows Cruz in the face. Rez comes in from Morte, but might be too little too late. Just have to see. Very good work here coming out from the offensive Misfits. Death Blossom here in the pub. Gonna get stunned out of it. And yet the offensive Misfits still moving forward.
Yeah, they're still dominating the left side of the kill feed here as Cruz comes in. He's gonna get Earth Shattered. Skipjack with a huge Earth Shatter.
Look at Crew gains that back, landing even more value, takes out Morte. That's the team wipe war, and then this should just be a leisurely walk here to the next checkpoint for the side of Misfits.
Yeah, no one's in position to even deny this at all. They're looking to get some poke in early. Soon is actually creep walking up, trying to get his poke on as well. I mean, they haven't really had an answer to Crew or Soon. I mean, they just are not dealing with the DPS players enough.
Speed boost is out here for the defense. They were looking to go in. They still might be looking to go in. They're rushing for it. Shade's almost dying in their attempt. Soundbear is out. Will there be a Death Blossom? I don't know if there's really opportunities. Offense really just backing out, taking their time, and letting the defense blow all their ults. Shade's though is going to be looking for the flank. He's going over the top. Wants to get a value Death Blossom. Will he be able to get it? Ends up getting pushed back, though, so not quite yet. Speed boosts out. He's going into the back line. Here he comes. Wraith form out to the back. Will he get value? No, he gets booped back. Death Blossom again. Out on the venue. Rough day for Shades of Gang, Death Blossom.
Yeah, I mean, he's just been caught out there pretty quick. Although Soon just got caught out himself by Valetaja. So that's a nice first kill for the defense. They look like they might want to go in off as Wringhaven was dancing around the front there. They're going to wait back, though. No reason to try to initiate this fight.
I love the back and forth from both teams right now. Both teams really using spacing to their advantage, knowing what the other team is looking for. The offense was down one, but they're moving in off the speed boost, going in deep in the back as Crew. Crew not dropping the barrage just yet, waiting for an opportunity. And look at Shade. Shade's now getting to backline. Has his time come? No, he's going to get stunned and killed by Crew instead. Not like this.
Yeah, unfixed.
Big Earthshatter coming down. Does knock down three here on the defense. Skipjack opening up. Reunited. Valetaj is still alive, but he's going to eat the hammer to the back of the head instead. Skipjack doing all sorts of work for his team. W-Mouse 1 in the house, and Reunited now in trouble, as this might be the victory march here for Misfits.
Yeah, Soon able to clean up some people too. Shades is going to come back in, try to get something done. He does have Death Blossom, but he has not found the space to use it. He gets cleaned up by Crew. Here comes the rush.
Here comes Soon. This might be a Death Blossom in the making. Right now, just laying in the damage in the Reinhardt, not going for anything too crazy. Deadeye is out on the defense, but here comes Death Blossom, gets right into the back, takes out Valetaja. Nullified by D.Va for the rest of it, but still, good luck here for the offensive Misfits. They only need a few more pickoffs. Sound Barrier is fading now for the defense and Shades. Do you have it in you? Can you get a good Death Blossom here? Not able to kill Mercy. Mercy got the res off before dying. Down goes Shades again, not going to be able to get the Death Blossom off as the offense just pushing forward. Reunited, trying to stall out here with Tracer, but that is going to be it. 2:42 left on the clock as Misfits going to complete things out.
Yeah, Crew had himself a great game there. I mean, Unfixed was trying to do his best on the Pharah's arrival there, but I think, again, just not the Reaper play that you're looking for. And it's just, a lot of it was just very tentative. At some point, you just got to mash Q and hope for the best. I mean, just wraithed in, wraithed out. A lot of times was unable to just really get off the clutch Q when you needed it. I think Valetaja was playing a better Reaper the other map. But I think, you know, like I said, if they are trialing him and they want to see, it, can we have someone fill that Reaper role, that and they're going to stick him on it.
So time-wise, that's about 6:18 left on the clock there. Not the fastest King's Road time, but definitely not the slowest either. I think that Reunited will have some troubles beating that time, but it is beatable. So I think both sides can take some degree of solace, although perhaps the offense of a Misfits just a tiny bit more.
All right, so offensively, I think Shade should be on this Hanzo. It's where he's had his best day on that hero, and it's a good map for it. So he is queued up right now on the Hanzo. Morte, Mercy. Cruz is on, for the moment, offensive 76, but he will very likely be playing Lucio. Wringhaven on Reinhardt. Unfixed is on the Pharah. Valetaja on his steady old McCree.
Nothing's gonna stop. Meanwhile, looking here at the offense as, or at the defense as it sets up here for the side of Misfits. It's gonna be Soon here on the Reaper. Zebosai on Lucio. Skipjack on Reinhardt. Nevix on Mercy. Crew on the Pharah. And Zapri gonna round things out here on the Winston.
All right, yeah, I really want Shades to be on this Hanzo. I think it's a smart pick. Like I said, he's just had his best day on it. Maybe he is a better Reaper than we've seen. He's just not feeling it today. That happens. But I think for them to have a good chance of beating this, he needs to be playing this Hanzo.
Well, Shades has definitely had a much better Hanzo day than he's had on Reaper. There's no doubt about it.
Right. So they're all in the back corner for some reason. It's a weird positioning from the defense. They are going to kind of come out now. I think they were just worried about maybe a scattershot arrow early on.
So they're moving in. Shay's right now looking for it. Going to get taken out immediately. Offense with three kills, so they're making most of it, even with Hanzo getting bopped. The defense underdressed right now. Look at Cruz just gunning things down here in the back. Has the double kill, looking for a little bit more. Winston actually pretty weakened here. Has to run away from Cruz, but Reunited. Oh my goodness, the attack, just everything going their way in the very beginning here.
Yeah, it's pretty fast first cap there. There's absolutely nothing that defense can do about it. They just have to sit all the way back. They're trying to get some long range damage in. They're trying to posture to hold around Crew, but Winghaven and Balataja are already there.
A bit of a rough go there for Misfits, not getting any value on their defense. They're just going to have to retry and hope for the best as they move forward. Downside for them though is that ults will be up here for Reunited much sooner than they are up for Misfits. So next defense here could be a little bit rough. Ultimate is ready. Go. Oh no, by the way, Shade's no longer on the Hanzo. Switching to the Reaper. Gonna try and make the Reaper work yet again here as he moves forward.
Well, they are running two tanks, and you do need to answer through that Winston, which is kind of an interesting choice on the defense. So I think the Reaper is the right call, just as hero-wise. It's going to be up to him to have a better Reaper.
We're checking them from Winghaven, but he got absolutely no value off it. The defense able to shield it away. Two quick kills, though, for the offense, as they move forward. Make it four as Shades and Crews getting in deep. And Crew, one of the last people remaining here, not able to get the value he was looking for.
Who's got the hot hand?
Meanwhile, look at Volataja. Volataja is still in the fight, landing left click after left click. McLeft click still a thing as Volataja picks up two.
I think Crew's coming off of Pharah, otherwise that was the worst barrage I've seen in a while.
My ultimate is charging.
There was no reason to use it there. He got nothing out of it. He's staying on the Pharah, so it's just a bad ult.
Yeah, he's gonna send the Pharah, but this has been a just blisteringly fast time coming up from Reunited. They've gotten everything they've wanted again. I'm not even sure Misfits can get onto this point in time.
No, they're gonna try. They're gonna rush in. Zapper gets immediately eliminated by his counterpart, and the opposing McCree soon also gets taken down as well. The Earth Shatter misses.
Three kills here for Reunited, or Reunited on the attack. Make it four, five kills, in fact.
They're rolling.
And that was just absolutely brutal. Everything went their way, and there hasn't even been too much in the way of big engages here. Just Misfits hasn't shown up yet in this game. And now, time-wise, they're gonna have to defend this for almost 4 minutes, and that is easier said than done.
Yeah, they just have not had really an answer to anyone or anything that Reunited's been doing. They're trickling in. Zapri dies yet again early on in the fight. That's a main damage source. Crew is way out of position. They're going to try to initiate. Here comes the sound.
Deathlosser goes in from soon, moving forward with the sound bear. The defense finally coming to life. They pick up four kills, moving Reunited right back. The resurrection, though, is still a thing. Reunited's not out of this fight yet. Crew, though, says, you are out of this fight. Justice raining from above. Gets the triple kill. Crew finally getting some value. As Reunited gang defeated not once, but twice on top of this payload. And Shade says, enough of this, I'm out.
Yeah, Crew with the redemption there, because he had a really, really awful barrage earlier. That one totally saved him, so very nice. They did have to use some ults to be able to hold that off. Unfix is going to have his barrage up for the offense momentarily.
So here we go, Reunited gang right back into it. They are in offense, they are in blue. And Unfixed and Voltage, a lot of vaults here at the play. They can use it to their advantage. Speed boost is out. They're not going in on just yet, but here comes Unfixed going for Crew over the top. Lands one rocket. Will he land the second? Crew in trouble. Has to back out. And look at the spacious created here by Unfixed from that move. And that was great. And Unfixed is going to take out Zapri anyways. Is he going to get Crew? Crew's in trouble here. One more rocket and down he goes. Not falling just yet, however, as both teams fighting out here on the top of the payload. More momentum than not, though, with Reunited. They pick up another two, now three kills. And Balataja, just beautiful left clicks come in. Here comes the Deadeye. Will this be the dagger? The double kill Deadeye coming in from Balataja. And Rez coming up from the offense. This should be it. Reunited has plenty of time left to finish out this game. Over 2 minutes. They might be evening up the series in the very beginning here on King's Row.
Yeah, Morte Tri has just stayed alive so well this game. They've been trying to deep dive when Skipjack has. And also, I mean, I really think Valtaja and McCree is great, not because of the left click, not because of right click, but Flashbang saves lives. He was saved his medic several times there as they were diving him, just the Flashbang to stun out an isolated target. I really think that once Flashbang gets rediscovered for the amazing utility it is, we'll start seeing a little more McCree.
And so we're going back in the lobby, waiting now on the next map. It will be, of course, Misfits' call, but Reunited, able to even things up. Now 1-1 here in the grand final. So that one game edge that Misfits had, it is gone.
We're effectively in a best of three. So the maps remaining on the table are Route 66, Volskaya, and Lijiang.
Oh, this is great. I mean, now that Volskaya is still in the pool, We have this go back and forth. We will see Volskaya in a finals. That is vintage Reunited.
Yeah, it's very, very possible. So I think we'll probably go to Route 66 next. They're saying Hollywood.
No, Hollywood.
I don't think Hollywood's in the map pool. Unless I'm looking at the wrong page.
I'm reminding the teams of what goes on. Walmart is just like, is it in the map pool? Yes.
No, Hollywood's not
in the map pool. Oh, is Hollywood in the map pool?
No. Not if we're doing a map pool of four, right? Four was going to be our map pool. So it's Lijiang, Volskaya, Route 66, Kings.
I'm letting them know that Volskaya is still there. I'm not being biased at all towards the picking of Volskaya, but I would like to see some Volskaya.
Yeah, I'm letting them know which maps are remaining, so.
So, Route 66, Volskaya, Lijiang. I assume of the three, we'd go to Route 66, but you never do know.
Yeah, you would think. So we're in a best of three for, you know, the grand title for our GosuGamers Overwatch Weekly number 14. Prize pool is at $1,100. The bulk of that goes to the winner. Of course, second place gets some cash, too. That is all furnished by our wonderful sponsors, G2A, Rockhats, and OWKings.com. And if you're looking for a party, we have a new tool that GosuGamers developers designed. It is pf.gg, partyfinder.gg. Look for people who want to play Overwatch the same way you do. There is no need to always solo queue. Though I like solo queuing sometimes.
Solo queuing, I mean, it's good and bad, right? Like, I like solo queue when everyone in the game is solo with me.
Yeah.
I don't like solo queue when you end up solo queuing and you have a four stack versus another four stack, because then it just turns into what team has the better four stack. But here we go. Lijiang Tower gonna be map number two. Cheers, love the cavalry. Probably about to be here.
Yay.
Hex, I need more enthusiasm from you.
Yay! That's it. That's all I got.
All right, gag a little bit better. Either way, Lijiang Tower is the next map on the agenda. No hero limit, of course. We have been seeing a lot of stacking strategies, especially as one team is about to lose. Letting them know that we are ready and we are good to go here. Map number two, Lijiang, about to be underway. Technically, map number three, if you count the one game advantage to Misfits going into this.
All right, we're entering game. All set. See some tracer action on Lijiang Tower.
Oh man, I'm gonna be honest. Given that I'm incredibly hungry now, seeing Twitch chat spam Dorito chips is just absolutely triggering me. Which I know saying that is gonna result in more Doritos chips, but the damage has already been done. I'm just starving.
Yeah.
Food for thought.
Lame. All right, so on Reunited, we're gonna see a couple tracers. That's gonna be Voltage and Unfixed. Morte will very likely be playing a second Lucio. Cruz also on Lucio. And for the first time, we've got Twinston's Winghaven and Chase.
Is Twinston coming out and it being in force? Has the prophecy been fulfilled? Oh, it's happening, Hex. Two Winstons, two Tracers, two Lucios. Jet Set Monkey Future. Here we go. Meanwhile, from the other side of Misfits, they're going to be running most of the same, except a Zarya in place of Double Scientist.
Yep. So Twinston, Tucio, Trey. Definitely happening. Whoa, yep. I got nothing. Nothing more to say about it.
Well, what if we had four Winstons, we'd say Planet of the Apes Civil War, but that is not a thing. Just yet. People watch here, of course, Voltage and Zapri, some of the best tracers in the game. They both had huge impacts on their team before, but the double Winston working out as Shades and Winghaven both picking up kills. Down goes both Lucios. All the healing is gone here for the side of Misfits, and Reunited in a good position here to take first control of this map.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, you can't lose both Lucios and then expect to contest a point. You're already 4v6, and that's all you're healing. The other team could just poke and out-heal you. They could retreat and run away. That's... and signals the end of most fights whenever you lose two other supports. Crew is going to come up on a Reaper instead. We'll see how his Reaper can deal with double Winston.
Yep, so no longer Zarya, now Reaper versus double Winston. The 2-2-2, long awaited, and they're even synced up here on the screen. It's two Winstons, then two Tracers, then two Lucios.
It's a little thing.
Crew getting right into it right now, trying to take out at least one of these Winstons. Not having a whole luck, he's getting electrocuted from both sides. Pulse Bomb does come out, though, takes out both Winstons. Both sides getting deep and dirty here on the point. But really back and forth. between both sides is Voltage Unfixed. The only two remaining here as Voltage is going to go down, and Unfixed will go down in turn as Soon absolutely exploding for 3 kills on the point.
Yeah, Soon putting this team on his back as he tallied, I think, about 5 kills during the last minute or so, able to flip that point around. Now they're in the aggressive position. They're holding outside front. Yeah, Winghaven has to back out.
Soon able to take out Winghaven. So the double Winstons are going to go down here. Misfits piling on the pressure. The one downside for them, though, going into the next fight, we're going to see not one, but 2 Primal Rages coming out here from the side of Reunited. And dealing with 1 Rampaging Monkey is hard enough, but you throw in 2, that's trouble.
Yeah, I'd actually like to see them take the point and then do their Primal Rages, because it's an area where you can get environmental kills.
Town Bear is coming up. Pulse Bomb does come in from Soon. Does bring Winghaven really low, but I gotta think we're gonna see Primal Rage. No, he's not able to Primal Rage in time. He got a little bit greedy on it, so he's gonna go down. Shades might go down as well. Primal Rage is though to save himself. Might not be the worst, though, as Crew with the Death Blossom plucking the fishes out. All the kills in the world going in favor of Misfits as they are hanging on to this point.
Yeah, Unfixed gets cleaned up as well. Cruz is going to have his Sound Barrier for the next push here, but that did not go well at all. Like you said, Winghaven not able to Primal Rage out of it and save himself, giving him 1,000 HP. He got kind of snuck up on, and of course it was Soon behind him, took him down. Soon's just doing everything he can. He's having a great Tracer game.
Well, Zapper and Soon both load for Bear. They both have Pulse Bombs on the way. They're going to be looking to throw these Pulse Bombs in the back. Sound Barrier, though, is out here for the side. Reunites the movement, and Soon bombed himself instead. Did not quite work out the way it was going. Pulse Bombs coming up from all sides. Explosions everywhere. Not even the 4th of July yet. Winghaven, though, getting in here. Primal Rage on the point. Bouncing things left, right, and center as Reunited in good position now to take this back for themselves.
Yeah, they're able to flip it over. 40% now, opposed to the 82%. So they're going to hold outside of the door here. It's been very back and forth. No real switch-ups yet on composition-wise.
So Soundbear going to be coming out here from the offense of Misfits. Misfits looking to turn this back in their favor, getting right back into it. Both teams trying up kills to start this off. Voltage about to pull up the Pulse Bomb. Does drop the Pulse Bomb, does not get the value he's looking for. Zapri, meanwhile, did blow up Shades, looking for a little bit more. Getting deep onto the point. Has Pulse Bomb at the ready, doesn't use it just yet. But overall, Soon and Zapri doing all sorts of work right now versus Reunited. They are going to retake this point. And if they do, this is going to be last ditch attempts here for Reunited. Will they go to maximum Tracer? They only have 13% left.
Yeah, it's going to really depend if they think they can get out here. I don't think they have to. I think this composition is fine right now. They're going to have Sound Barrier. They do have a little bit of time. Here comes the Sound Barrier.
They're going to have double Primal Rage too, so they don't want the Winston to switch off just yet. The Winstons are going to leap onto that point. Shade's going to have Primal Rage up in here in just a moment. Winghaven, though, not able to get it up in time. He goes down instead as Crew gets the triple kill. Death Blossom taking out 3 Soon with the follow through.
That's it.
And the cavalry is not going to arrive here.
Yeah, Reaper's pretty good.
I like how the ship door actually closes at the end. It's like, wait a second. 0-1. 0-1, fair. Misfits, bringing this back.
Yeah, Crew looked really good there. I mean, it's the one difference on their roster is that Crew is not playing Winston. He was playing either Zarya or Reaper. Made the switch to Reaper when he noticed that it was double Winston. And yeah, Reaper can have trouble against that, but he just found a way, held that Death Blossom to the opportune time. I think really the Death Blossom is perfect to try to close out a map like this because you're going to have this spam and jumping on the point. It's really hard to close out over times in King of the Hill. Death Blossom is a great tool for that. You saw it right there with the 4K in the end. He is back on Zarya now, though. And
now we have 3 Tracers out for Reunited. Yeah. We've seen Reunited tilt like this before where in hero stacking, where they've done 3 Winstons. Now they're doing not 1, not 2, but 3 Tracers. Cavalry has arrived early. Let's see if this works out for them.
What an interesting, diverse tactic, adding in a 3rd Tracer.
Unfixed able to take out Skipjack now. Shade's getting to the back line, looking for a little bit more. Both sides trading out here. Neither side with a huge advantage just yet. Blue and Red filling the kill feed, but Zapri now doing his best to put his team on the back with the aid of Soon to get 1 more kill here from the side of Misfits. This should be it. The one downside, though, for Misfits is that dealing 3 Tracers, Tracers are going to be able to keep zooming in onto the point.
Yeah.
There is no end.
Oh, they were so close to getting it there, too. Voltage comes in. They are able to get it over. Now they do have both Pulse Bombs, too. You can see them probably trying to land those on the bridge. I would love to see the Tracers go a little further forward. We've seen on this map especially, you can actually hold right outside their front door. With Tracer, with Rewind, things like that, you're almost always safe. I think they're holding a little far back, but it seems to be working for them. They have eyes on where where Reunited wants to approach from. Reunited doesn't even know where they want to go in yet. They're going to have to go in big door.
Zephyr now going to back, not able to get quite what he's looking for. Has to rewind back out, does not get it just yet. But oh my goodness, the stick in the back takes out Voltaja. Almost got a little bit more soon, able to pile on. And I gotta say right now, the biggest difference between the two teams, I feel like the Tracer play of Misfits has been a little bit better. Even though Voltaja is great, I feel like Unfix has not been doing quite as much work as soon. And the 1-2 combo of Zapri soon really doing wonders here for the side of Misfits.
Yeah, no, they've absolutely been outplaying them on Tracer. I mean, Soon just had a couple moments where he puts the entire team on his back. They're playing extremely safe. And then adding crew in, I mean, he's giving them shields as well. So that's a huge boon to their performance and the ability to dive deep. Also, crew's gonna have this Graviton to try to lock out the map again. Right now, there's a big engagement as Wing Haven comes over the top. Soundbearer is off both sides.
The Graviton is out. Everyone getting in. The group hug is real. They don't get any follow-up immediately, but Zoom does get the Pulse Bomb, takes out Shades. Two quick kills here for Misfits. They are piling in, moving into the Reunited squad. And 2-2-2 not quite working out for Reunited right now. Maybe they would be better off with the Zarya in over the second instant.
Yeah, so they've just absolutely been cleaning up these Pulse Bombs, have found sticky targets every single time. I love this area denial on the door. I think Zarya is perfect here, just lobbing so much damage, already at 40% on that Graviton again.
The offense reunite gang right in here. Soundbearer is out, both Winstons are in. Wingaven has Primal Rage at the ready. It is just monkeys everywhere right now. Three Winstons in the fray. Wingaven gonna take out Skipjack. Down one scientist. As Reunited now, their best push that they've had here so far. Nevik's in trouble, just getting electrocuted by this Winston. And we even could go Primal Rage, he will do that. Down to 15 HP before he does it. Really taking it to the limit, but overall, Misfits actually starting to fight this back off some really phenomenal Tracer play coming out from Soon.
Yeah, Soon got a couple picks there. They're actually going to be able to bring this back. Skipjack's going to join him on the point. They need to protect Nevix right here. Nevix is able to rollerblade up the wall, protect himself.
So they're getting in, three kills here for Reunited. Reunited not done just yet. Voltaja back into the fray, looking for crew in the back. Crew can shield himself, making this not the easiest, but with the support of another Tracer, they do get in. It is overtime now too here for Reunited. So Reunited, they can't get off the point for any reason. We are entering Tracer Ground Zero.
Well, actually, I think that they'd be better, Misfits, to just kind of, he's gonna stall out the point. They don't wanna have to flip it back over. So they are gonna have Graviton and some of their Pulse Bombs up, but yeah, they do end up having to give it up. Oh, let's break
it. Still though, not the worst look here for Misfits. If Misfits can retake the same point, they should win. Big Graviton coming up here, followed by a Pulse Bomb. Wombo combo in the house, Zapri picking up two. Moving in now for Misfits. They're wiping out this Reunited squad, and Reunited might not even have time for the Tracer delay shenanigans. I don't think they will. I think this is going to be overtime in favor of Misfits.
Winston Lee doesn't get there.
Oh, Shades, not like this. He got booped back into the pit.
Very rough. Score 0-2.
Well, these have actually been somewhat quick and finish off King of the Hill map, so that's good. Really the only thing to look at as far as these compositions go. Well, now that we're on this stage, are they going to start running Pharahs in here too? Crew has been absolutely doing work on his one-off class on Zarya. The Gravitons were absolutely crucial, and I think that's one of the big reasons that these Tracers are getting so much work done, is that they have these allied shields. They've been diving pretty deep. They're just staying much more alive, because it is essentially like adding in a third support in some sense, because Zarya is just great. She's super useful in that way.
No, she is super useful, and Zarya will be in play here. No Pharah coming out, as Reunited now has to pull the reverse sweep here on Lijiang if they want to win this map and not go down 2-1. Zapri right now, though, getting right into the thick of things, going for Shades in the back. They are just focusing Shades so ridiculously hard. Shades, though, able to hang in here thus far. Unfixed the first pick of the game, able to take out Skipjack. Very close, though, between both teams. Reunited about to lose two people. Shades will go down after that incredibly intense focus. But overall, Reunited getting a little bit better of this fight, and they should be able to get first capture.
Yep, pretty nice first cap there, as they were able to take that point rather easily. Zephyr is going to have Pulse Bomb up momentarily, so that's going to be the first thing to look for to see if this team can bring it back. Although, you know, both of the Tracers
Pulse Bomb goes in the back. Unfix takes out Crew immediately. Crew's gonna be down for this entire fight. Voltaja hunting the Lucios, takes out Nevix, and even though Zapri is Pulse Bomb, might just be better served by backing out here, because down two people that early, you are not gonna win that fight.
So, Zapper still was unable to get his pulse bomb off. They're gonna have both of those up. Skipjack is nearly on his primal rage. They're all grouped up now. Next big fight incoming.
They're gonna be coming in here. Zapper right now looking for the pulse bomb. Has shades in his sight. Soundbear, though, going to make that a little bit less of an option. Pulse bomb goes off. They're double pulse bombing shades. Shades able to live. At least for now, Shades though will go down soon right after. The focus from the double tracer on the Zarya is real. Sound barrier out from both sides as they are getting deep onto the point. Both teams down a player. Who is going to win? Does look like Misfits with a little bit of an edge here. They were able to push things out, but Voltage is taking out Crew and running it right back for Reunited.
Yeah, Crew dying in the back there is kind of rough because he had Graviton up. They would like to keep him in this fight. Skipjack does have Primal Rage up, so I think they're going to keep sustaining this fight. Zabo gets knocked off the edge.
Rip Zebo running into Winghaven in the wrong area. The pulse bomb's coming out here from the side of Reunited, just doing all sorts of work as they are keeping Misfits back and well on their way to bringing out this round set to 1-2, staying alive. However, Crew is coming in here with the Graviton Surge. We can get good value off this. Zapri does have the Pulse Bomb, so get three or four people in. Fall, Pulse Bomb, here comes the Graviton. Gets a few people in. Does Zapri hit the fall through? Bomb explodes! Three people go down! And Misfits, just like that, might be able to retake this point after all.
Yeah, it's her last best chance. You just have to clean up Crews and Unfixed on the point. There goes Crews, down goes Unfixed. That should be a flip.
Good Graviton sang that up. Good Wombo. And now we'll see if Shades can do the same here for his team. Although they're only, they don't have a pulse bomb up just yet. They're gonna have to wait for Unfix. Shade should absolutely wait for his tracers to get pulse bomb up before firing this. In any rate. So Shade's right now laying in the right click poke, waiting for an opportunity. Unfix almost has a pulse bomb built up, needs 10% more. Once he has that, I do think Shade's gonna go in. He's gonna try and turn this to his favor, just like Misfits did to them a moment ago. And now they can go. Like, Unfix is gonna have pulse bomb up. This is a time where they need to speed up. Shades needs to go in. And look for it here, and that's exactly what's gonna happen. He's moving in. Soundbearer is out. Where is the Graviton Surge? He's waiting for an opportunity. Both sides with the Soundbearer, both relatively protected here. Pulse bomb goes off. No kills for him just yet. More Soundbearers coming down from both sides. Every Lucio breaking down. There is the Graviton Surge, but it only gets one person in it. Not the highest value as Misfits trying to hang on here. Ults going off on both sides. Every Lucio has broke it down. And now it's just down the Tracer v Tracer action here in the point as Zapri able to assassinate Morte.
Yeah, Crews is finding himself in a rough spot too. He's probably going to get chased down and killed. Morte is down, so losing both of your supports is always brutal. Not going to be all the healing up, but whether both Lucios remain up for Misfits.
They're staying in there, but Reunited coming right back in. Voltage making some things happen, if nothing else. As three, four kills now for Reunited. Reunited gave back on this point, and if they retake it, this is going to be do or die time for Misfits. Misfits is going to have to just run onto the point over and over again without any sort of relief. But no, they're not even able to trigger overtime, so Reunited staying alive. We're going to round four.
Barrier activated. Got Graviton there towards the end, able to lock it out, and that's exactly what you need on King of the Hill maps to prevent that, you know, kind of trickling on and the Tracer strat to really just keep a map going forever. A lockout alt like a Graviton is perfect.
Alrighty, so we are getting into another round of the Night Market stage. Both teams going to be running Azaria. So done is the 2-2-2 of Reunited. They prefer having Azaria in the mix as well.
Yeah, I just,
but,
really
good
just
games
too good
so far from both teams.
One, it's you can actually end up really getting charged up just based on the pulse bombs. If you get stuck, you just hit your shift and then you have 100% charge pretty much. And also, it just helps your tracer and it allows your Winston to jump in deep like that, like Winston just did.
Well, both teams getting into it. Both teams still full strength, looking for the all-important first pick. Once one team gets the first pick, the other team's going to be way more aggressive at going in. You see it all the time, but they both lose people simultaneously. Both Tracers, though, are down for Misfits. Their engines of DPS are gone. Five kills here for Reunited, and that is going to be first capture in favor of Reunited.
Yeah, they look like a different team after that first point. Bringing it back now, they're looking to kind of tie it up in 2-2 on our King of the Hill. So they've just looked better. Overall, Voltage and Unfix are just playing better early on.
Pulse bomb will stick from Voltage. Almost kills Winston, gets saved by the Zarya shield instead. Offense from Misfits gang right in, and note that crew is charged up here off of that pulse bomb. Shades takes him out before. Hey, Shades is still alive. So, but 20 HP, Shades hanging in there. We'll finally go down the skipjack. Soundbearer coming out here from the side of Misfits in the end, but they're down their tracers. This is not the greatest look. Soon though, was able to get back in the fight, took out two in the back. And they're starting to turn it in their favor. Soon making his grand entrance right back in. Picks up another kill. Soon being unleashed.
Yeah, he's been phenomenal for them. He's been the best part of the team so far on King of the Hill, especially as he goes, so goes their team.
Misfits is making the case here. They are on the point. They are pushing Reunited back. Reunited swarming in. The pulse bomb goes off on Shade. Shade's though able to shield himself. Not going to be enough though as crew finishes off the kill. Big sound bear coming out here from Misfits, and I think at this point Reunited needs to stop throwing good money after bad. Back up and regroup. They are not going to retake this right now.
Well, I don't even know if they're looking to retake it. They're looking to stall out.
No, they're looking to stall it out, but the only problem is that they're still going to... I get it. They still get percentage while it's going on, but still... It can be rough, because now they're going to have to regroup fully. And look at it right now. It's a pretty good position coming out from Misfits.
Yeah, they are set up. I think Misfits wants to fight kind of on the point now, but I think they should be out here with their tracers on the front lines. You're not really ever in danger with tracer over here. There's giant packs. You've got two Lucios, so they should be getting a little more poke in. Now they're actually poking as a team over here.
They will have a wombo combo on the menu here in a moment. Soon's about that pulse bomb. Crew has Graviton. Graviton is out. Grabs three people in the middle of this Graviton, but there's no big follow-up. Although I guess Primal Rage Winston isn't the worst. Was able to land swipe after swipe. Three big kills here coming out after that Graviton. Four Misfits. And they're going to hold on here yet again. And by the way, please note that they already have two rounds to their name, so if they win this round, that is if they take this map away from Reunited.
Yeah, nearing about 50%, almost tying up the percentage point scores here, and both of their tracers have their pulse bombs up. I mean, there's four pulse bombs on the table right now. Everyone's loaded up, and Zebosai is going to be able to save someone with a drop the beat, and Nevix is going to have his shortly after, too. So a better position here for Misfits, ultimately.
Reunited moving right in. They do have a bunch of ults. Shades does have the Graviton. Gets a huge value off that. Where's the pulse bomb? Pulse bomb's coming in. Wombo combo is unfixed. Blows up three. Good day to be a fan of Graviton and the pulse bomb. As Reunited coming in force, really good Graviton coming out from Jades.
Yeah, it's a pretty good combination there. Soon and Zapper are trying to do the best on the point. They get cleaned up pretty late. Their Reunited flips it back over.
I just want to note how they set that up too. They all ran in the point, ignoring her in the courtyard. The defense of Misfits reacted to that immediately and just got suckered into that Graviton. Still a little bit of rough times coming out there as offensive Misfits coming back in. Very even percentage-wise. Soundbearer, though, out here from Reunited. There is no Soundbearer up for the side of Misfits, so a little bit rough as Zebosai about to bite the dust here. Won't have any healing up for a while as far as Soundbearer goes, but no, he's going to get to the big health pack. Will live at least for now. Pulse Bomb's though coming out from Unfixed and Voltage. Going to do some serious damage in the backline as once again Misfits starting to bleed out, and now have we hit the point of no return? Will Tracers be on the way?
Only time will tell.
Well, we're going up on the point. Overtime is in progress now. If Tracers are coming, they need to be coming in here relatively soon. Zebosai and Nevix are still up, though. They're getting the point. They're breaking it down. Double sound barrier coming out from both of them. Pulse bombs coming in as well from Reunited. It is pandemonium on the point, and Crew is almost certainly going to be on a Tracer after he finishes respawning. So a little bit of craziness on the point. Certainly Reunited is on the winning side of these fights. And Crew actually did not switch Tracer. Crew staying on the Zarya. He wants to put his faith here in the Graviton Surge as Misfits actually fighting this back right now. They're getting the kills they need to. They've taken away Reunited's dominance. If they can get one or two more picks, that might be it, as Crew now is going to have a Graviton in just a moment for not switching off.
Yeah, there is that
Graviton. Graviton is in. Doesn't pull anyone into it.
It's a zoning.
Might not matter, though, as Misfits still with momentum here on the point.
Yeah, here comes the Soundbearer too, which is absolutely crucial. They needed it at that time as Windhaven still is cleaving on the point, attempting to get kills. Voltage comes in late, but soon is able to clean up most of it.
So Misfits fighting, they're bringing this right back. This is not a one round yet for Reunited, and now Reunited going to be in the hot seat.
Oh, very back and forth. This entire match, really. Zapri and Soon have their pulse bombs up. Balotage and Unfixed almost there, too. So, I mean, whoever's going to get their sticky on is probably going to swing the fight in favor.
Soundbearer coming up from Reunited. Here comes the Graviton in just a moment. Shade's going to fire it in. Does get some value off this. Reunited swarming in off of that Graviton, picking up three kills. Only Zapri and Soon remain. And I got to think Tracers will be out here regardless. They need to keep this in overtime. as Reunited is now re-grabbing this point. Down, Wing Haven gonna take out soon. Zapri is dead. Crew, one of the last hopes for even touching the point. I'm not sure he's gonna get there in time. He does get there in time, and oh no, it begins! QED.
Well, Zebo goes down early. Winghaven is able to cleave on Glebosai, Zebosai early. Here comes Skipjack. It's just going to be mayhem down here. Here comes the sound barrier.
Sound barrier comes out from Reunited. Will save Unfix. Unfix actually got rewind as well to get rid of that stick. Zebosai and Nevixo staying on Lucio, so maybe a Tracer isn't about to hit the point. And there you have it. 2-2. It is now going to come down to the fifth and final round in this best of five. Oh, it's best of five on King of the Hill and best of five on the series, so. Lots of Overwatch today. As we will settle it all here on the Garden.
It's the last stage of King of the Hill for the day.
My ultimate is charging.
It is guaranteed to be the last stage of King of the Hill. In all forms and respects, unless the teams were going to say, nah, we don't want to do Volskaya, we don't want to do Nepal again, in which case, they would still play Volskaya. Sorry. They have no say here. This is no democracy.
Well, Misfits looked good on this stage earlier. They looked the best they've looked on this stage. So there's something about it that seems to favor them going into this. So we'll see what the compositions are. Twinston, Tucio, Traitre, adding in Azaria.
Oh, they're moving in. Zarya gonna get charged up immediately here. Shade's getting some good value off that shield as Zapri and Soon once again charging into the back. Looking for the ult for first pick off is Unfixed, though. Takes out Skipjack, so not the worst coming out from Unfixed. First kill of the game here to Reunited. Let's see if they can pile on it. Evix and Zoom, though, coming out with two kills of their own. And just like that, Misfits retaking the momentum. If they get one or two more kills here, that should be first capture to them.
Yeah, Crude does die off a cliff, though. Nevix is able to take down Morte pretty early on. Yeah, they're definitely steamrolling this over the point now. Cruz is going to try to stall it out. Here comes one of the Tracers in Valtaja. Not enough.
It's Tracer v Tracer all around the middle right now, and Zapri going to take it though. First capture point going in favor of Misfits.
Yep, so they're going to try to spam out over the bridge. They are just running right over the bridge. I think that's a kind of a misplay.
Wait, they're rolling right in.
Yeah.
They're wasting any time. Winghaven takes out Crew immediately here in this fight. Zapri going to throw out a pulse bomb. Is going to connect, takes out Valtaja. Meanwhile, looking at soon, another pulse bomb on the way. Not able to connect right off the bat. So though, if Misfits gets another kill, they should be able to hold on to this point. Shades will go down. Was off on an island by himself, and now Misfits, even though they are bleeding a little bit here in this fight, should be their fight, but I don't know. Voltage now getting back into it. Two kills for Reunited. Very scrappy here. The important thing, though, is that while it's even, it is still percentage being gained for the side of Misfits. So they're okay with this fight the way it is right now.
Yeah, just happy to stall out. Skipjack is able to take down Cruz early on. They're trying to group up our Reunited on the left-hand side, but Skipjack just keeps disrupting the back line. Winghaven's actually having himself a really good game. He's probably getting the most damage done for Reunited.
Soundbearer, though, does come in from Misfits. Misfits looking to clean up the remaining members here of Reunited. Cruz has a Soundbearer, but he has only three people alive total, including himself. He's going to have to wait as both Lucio's actually a little bit far out here. I think Cruz is going to have to bite the dust here, because he's not going to do it. He needs to go back.
Yeah, so now I think they're in better position. They actually have eyes on the bridge. They're being able to deny entry over this doorway. I think Crew is probably going to be saving this Graviton, maybe to lock the game out, unless they need it much earlier.
All right, so we see Voltage going in. Will land the stick directly. Does not get the kill due to the sound barrier, but still sets his up team up damage-wise. Big Graviton, though, coming in. Sets up Soon. Soon able to get the double kill off the back of that. Very back and forth by both teams, though, as Unfixed able to get value in the back as well, so going absolutely crazy between both sides here. Reunited still struggling to pull this back, and they might be doing just that at 98%, no less.
My ultimate is almost ready.
My goodness. Skipjack not going to go Primal Rage there. Just going to save it. Wait for a team to regroup. They do have a lot of time to retake this middle.
Yep, so now they're in the same position here where they're just going to try to deny over the doorway. Both Tracers coming right over the center, though, kind of ruins their plans of area denial as the rest of the team is going to trickle in over the bridge.
Soundbearer coming in here from the side of Misfits. Misfits looking to close the door on Reunited. Graviton out. Three people in. Voltage, though, doesn't care. Lands a big bomb in the back. Takes out two. As Reunited trying to hang on. Zapri, though, putting the team on his back. Has two kills here so far. Looking for a little bit more. In comes the pulse bomb. Sticks the shades and deletes him. Zapri having himself a fight here. Trying to pull his team from the clutches of defeat in this fight. Soon piling on, and this is it. We're going to see Misfits retake this point, barring some sort of miracle play from Reunited.
Yeah, Voltage is still dancing around, though. He's been very elusive.
He is being elusive, but eventually Zapri going to find his target, gets right in there. Excuse me. And definitely all the men in the world right now in favor of Misfits. Soon and Zapri piling on.
They are going to flip it. Are they going to be able to deny overtime?
The overtime coming in, and now here comes Reunited. Will Reunited be able to keep this going? They have to keep piling on as tracers. They have three tracers here so far. Can we get four? Jade's, of course, now on tracer. Winghaven still to Winston, not switching off just yet. Rotom, though, coming up. They're going to pile on, take out three more members of Reunited. Let's break it down, says Morte. Morte, though, let's just break it dead. He is immediately taken out. Voltage and Unfix getting onto the point. And we are now up to four tracers. Now five tracers in play as Reunited looks for the Hail Mary to keep this game still a game.
Close to closing it out. Here comes Morte in the end.
Oh, Morte's not going to be able to turn the corner. And there it is. It is going to be Misfits map. Misfits now up 2-1 here in the grand finals, putting Reunited on match point. Or sorry, putting themselves on match point. Reunited facing elimination.
Yep, Zapri and Soon just, I thought, played phenomenal tracers there. Not a whole lot more to say about it. Just mechanically had really good games when they needed it. This is very clearly their best stage, as they won it twice. Yeah, they look good. Signed a King of the Hill for the day.
So 24 minutes on Lijiang Tower.
37,000 damage.
It's a lot of damage being done by Soon. Not gonna lie.
All right, so we're either going to Volskaya or what's the last map?
Last map, it's either Volskaya or Route 66. Okay. It is a Reunited's choice. Reunited, give us the classic. Bring us to Volskaya. You know you want to. They're gonna say they don't want to, but some hidden part of them deep inside probably wants to bring us to Volskaya.
Well, I imagine we're going to Route 66.
Most likely.
You would think.
You would think, but what if Volskaya?
I don't even know how our rule set works on Volskaya, to be honest. We just run the comp rules?
We run the comp rules, time bank.
Okay.
But it is going to be Route 66. Morte does flip it there. So if Reunited is able to win this, it will be a truly a classic final, as the fifth and final game will be played on Volskaya. And we've seen Reunited in this situation before.
Yeah, and it's never worked out for them.
No, absolutely not.
They have lost finals on Volskaya in the past. So we're just waiting for the teams to ready up. We'll be hopping into it. You are watching GosuGamers EU Weekly number 14. About $1,100 on the line. Of course, our sponsor is G2A Rocket, owkings.com. And if you're looking for a party, use our new tool, pf.gg. It's been a long day.
Alrighty, so it's going to be Misfits on the attack first. They're taking attack away from Reunited this time around. Not too surprising. But should be good to go here in just a moment. And historically, this has been a pretty good map for Reunited, but they did look a little bit more mortal on it earlier today, even though they did win. So we'll see. I think maybe a slight edge to Reunited still going into this map, but I do think Misfits does have a pretty good chance of ending this right here, right now, on map number 4.
Yeah, I mean, it's a pick'em game, kind of coin flip. Reunited has looked fine on it, but I'm not entirely sure. As long as they don't give up the high ground and go fight early for some reason, and they stay on big earls, the first point defense should be better than what we saw earlier today. So they are going to choose to attack first, are the Misfits.
So we're getting game here. For those who are just tuning in, Misfits is now up 2-1 over Reunited, looking to put this weekly away for their share of the $1,000 prize pool. Actually, a little bit more than that now, thanks to, of course, all your guys' great donations on Matcherino, like Friedolf saying, heart, $10. Very much appreciated.
That's an awesome donation.
Just heart.
So all you need is love.
And $10.
Can $10 buy love? Just don't. Just leave it.
I mean, is a pack of Chicken McNuggets love? Because if so, yes.
Yeah, fair enough. Good point.
This chat's just like Dan's game, the Nuggets. Look, what do you want, Chipotle? Do you want food poisoning? Because that's how you get food poisoning.
You know the McNuggets and Chipotle are owned by the same people, right?
I don't think McDonald's, they have a stake in Chipotle. I don't think they actually own Chipotle.
Well, whatever, like, that's semantics. Anyway.
It's like 10% of your burrito might be going to McDonald's. Just like if you go to a Five Guys restaurant, you have a 10% chance of it being owned by Shaq. Okay. He owns over 10% of all the Five Guys that are in the nation right now.
Mr. Shaquille O'Neal. All right.
Next time you go Five Guys, you enjoy a good burger. Just know that you might be giving a little bit of money to the great one himself.
Can you dig it? On defense, Valetage is going to be playing McCree. Cruz is looks like he's going to be running this Soldier 76, which we've seen on this map all day. Morte will be playing the Mercy. Shades is going to play that Reaper, Windhaven on Reinhardt, unfixed on Pharah. So this has just been super standard stuff from Reunited all day.
Pretty much nothing too much surprising there. Meanwhile, looking at the offense coming out from the Misfits, it's going to be Zapre on Roadhog, soon on Reaper, Zebosai on the Lucio, Nevix on Mercy, Crew going to potentially be on the offensive Hanzo, though really he's just been using it to check. He'll use it to check and then he'll switch to something else like a Pharah and Skipjack on the Reinhardt. So I'm not really expecting Crew to stay on the Hanzo.
Yeah, he's just making sure there's no Presidents or Torbjorns lurking about. He might stick on it, though.
I mean, he always has the option to stick on. It just hasn't been the case here thus far. Dragon awakens.
I'm on the payload and moving out. I'm trying to get some damage with that early scatter shot. They're just going to come around the corner. Big fights always happen on Big Earl, so I'd expect the brawl to take place momentarily. Cruz is taking some damage on the right side. He needs to be careful. He's got to get out of. He's way out of position now. His soldier. He can't even hold the right side.
Yeah, he has to be careful. He just needs to back out and not throw good money after bad. Shades, of course, will be on the Reaper again. He's had some trouble with this character as the day has gone on. We'll see if he can get some redemption here. But Gunnery and I, though, they're still holding onto the roof. They're not giving up rooftop positioning. They should be able to just collapse on this here in a moment as Shades right now moving around, going to the back line, and looking again. Zapri in a bit of trouble. Shades, though, has to Wraith form out as Crew and soon they do pick up two kills, so even though Reunite was able to hold rooftop positioning, they did not make the most of it. And we see Misfits now just slowly picking them apart. Whereas they come up from Morte, does bring up some Fallen Heroes. The defense of Reunite not have it just yet as Crew going to go down the Voltage and not winning the fair beat fight. Now might be high noon sooner than you might think as Voltage McLeft clicking his way to glory right now, just throwing left click after left click into the shield. Gang right on the Skipjack and down goes the barrier and back goes the offense.
Yeah, Nevix was trying to fly there and got taken down by an errant hammer somewhere in that fight. Really slowed down the offense, unable to have that resurrection up to reinforce it, and now it's a full reset for the most part.
Sound Baron now coming up here from the side of Misfits. They're moving in, looking for some value. Not able to get just yet. Valtaja, though, has to save the Deadeye, doesn't get what he's looking for.
Wow, huge Earth Shatter on the cart, knocks down four. Not really the follow-up there, as Windhaven's trying to do it alone.
Oh, Cruz has the follow-up over the top, though. Guns down two, looking for more, follows through. And what Windhaven sets up, Cruz is able to knock down. Anyone need some healing? So for the defense coming up here, Shades is about to have a big Death Blossom potentially on the menu if he's able to land it. Meanwhile, from the offense, they are getting close to ults of their own. Soon used Death Blossom in the last fight, did not quite get it. But Barrage, Earth Shatter, all going to be potential options for them as they move forward.
Yeah, his holds look really good so far. Cruz actually begins this fight by taking out Zebo. They just didn't see him, I think, or Zebo was peeking at the wrong angle. Absolutely, it hurts that fight to start out the potential.
Look at Jade's now going to back. Will he use the Death Blossom? Not using it just yet. That was a great opportunity, and he's just going to get pushed back instead.
Heroes never die. Well, the
see Voltage right now in the back line trying to deal Zapri. Right clicking, Mick right clicks him right down. Justice. And even though this has been a little bit sloppy here, Voltage being the rock picks up another kill on the Crew as Justice was writing. See the Barrage coming in from Unfixed as well, and the offense isn't totally out of this yet, but they are slowly getting picked apart by Cruz and Voltage. Zebosai comes out of nowhere and just melees down Voltage, so a little bit back and forth, but still very much in favor of Reunited right now, and Crew actually going to swap off the Pharah, going to 76 instead.
Yeah, I mean, they need something. They're definitely not getting what they want out of their Pharah, and really one of the biggest problems for them has been Unfixed. And, you know, one of the best ways to answer that is Soldier 76. It's going to be up to Crew to be able to hit that, but it's pretty much their last push coming up here.
You see Windhaven on the point, does have Earth Shatter at the ready. For Reunited, they would love to end this map relatively early. Earth Shatter comes down, gets zero value. Just a terrible Earth Shatter coming in from Reunited. Zapri, though, picking up the double kill, turning this... bending this fight to as well, going for the hook on the Morte, not able to get it just yet. Morte very close to getting res. He needs to kill Morte now. Morte does go down. And just like that, we're going to have Misfits move in and get the payload forward. But I gotta say, fault for that definitely falls on Wingham to some extent. He completely whiffed his shot.
Yeah, he's been either nailing them or absolutely missing, because the earlier one he had in that fight knocked down five and they absolutely cleaned up. So there's really been no in-between with Wingham today. He's either been playing great or playing poorly. I mean, Earthshatter is such an impactful ultimate, but you know, when you miss it, you're also losing out on so much impact too.
You see the Death Blossom coming in now from the side of the offense. No. I'm not getting anything with it. It didn't even look like he was near anyone. I'm not really sure. It seemed like a little premature. Unfixed coming in over the top, looking for his opportunity in the barrage, measuring the team, looking for Zebosai, gonna land rocket after rocket. And here comes the barrage, will immediately delete crew, looking for more. Zebo going to go down as well. Rez comes in right after, not going to bring him back up. Jade's right now still hanging on to his Death Blossom, has not been able to land good Death Blossoms all day. Fighting soon in the back right now. Will he win? Is getting healed by the Mercy and will take out soon.
Nevix in trouble here as he's trying to retreat on Mercy. He gets a couple pistol shots and he's somehow still alive. Does get taken out eventually by Valetaja.
Death Blossom is ready.
Pretty good defense coming out from Reunited right now. They're setting themselves up for glory and they might not even have to defend last the way this is working if they can win at least one more team fight.
I am ready to revive you.
So, all the ults up in the world here for the defense. They have a lot of things going for them. So for the offense, not so much. They have Earth Shatter and Whole Hog. Not your greatest for breaking something open.
No, they need to do kind of the slow push and take the top, because Wingham's just been hanging out here up top, and then you let Valetaja get behind him and just click away and be completely safe behind the shield. They need something to initiate and crack this. It looks like they're just going to bully him off the top.
Valetaja sniped out crew immediately with the McLeft clicks. Shade's right now looking for an opportunity. Is going to get knocked back a bit by the Whole Hog. Not able to go in just yet, but has been holding on to this Death Blossom basically all game. So Soundbearer coming in. He's going to move in off the Soundbearer. Death Blossom coming in. And he just gets juked away, does not get any value off the Death Blossom. The rest of the offense, though, is moving in. Big Earthshatter comes in for Wingham, knocks down two. And they might be taking this fight anyways, even though Arez is going to bring some people back up into the fight.
Well, Shades may have not got kills off the Death Blossom, but he did clean up two in the back lines anyway. Now Valetaja gets into the mix as well. Another couple kills, only three up for the offense here. Death Blossom comes in for them, that's soon.
Valetaja just laying in the damage. Valetaja being a standout player here, and honestly, part of the reason why Reunited had trouble is that they got away from McCree after the nerf, but man, is Valetaja still good on, and they are going to have a full hold, and this is where it's a little bit different. It's not, we're not doing stopwatch for partial holds, we are doing the in-game distance system.
Yep.
So all Reunited has to do to win this map now is simply bring the payload further than Misfits was able to bring it, and they will be able to even this up 2-2, and we will be going to Volskaya.
Why not?
Yes.
Yeah, it's been a strange day map-wise.
Actually, Hex, I just realized you might have lied to our viewers and lied to me.
Wait, what? Is that not in the
pool? Yes. Because the way the rules go, going off, we're stealing a little bit off the Gamescom rule set for this. If, and keyword if, we go to Volskaya and it's a tie, we will go to a random King of the Hill map in order to decide who is the winner.
Okay.
So just so you know, if Volskaya is a tie, King of the Hill still might be on the table.
All right.
The cavalry might have its revenge yet.
Yeah, I'm just going to DC if that happens.
I'm going to blame
Comcast and say something happened.
I can't believe Comcast attacked. Well, chat, I will never betray you as Hex would. I will stay in till the bitter end, but I also have Comcast, so you never know.
I think chat would understand.
I'm just saying.
Okay, well, offensively, the defense, they're running double Reaper on this defense, which I think is pretty interesting. I have yet to see it really today. It's not in response to anything, because they don't know what the offense is running, but the offense, you know, it's Soon and Zapri on these Reapers, Skipjack is going to be on Winston, Nevix on Mercy, Zebo will be playing Galusio, and Crew on the defensive Soldier 76, so a lot of damage here, a single tank.
Hopefully makes sense, and we'll see how things work out here, as both teams about to be on the way. Of course, the offense is in blue, not on red. Do not be fooled, and that offense, if they can do it, Shade's taking up the Genji Mantle. Unfixed now in the Reaper instead. So again, bear in mind, we are doing payload further. This is the comp rule set that is in game for this right now, since there is no sudden death in play. If they're able to get the payload to the next checkpoint, Reunited will be the victor, so not a lot of room to work with here for the defense.
Yeah, Unfixed comes in, takes down Soon right away. Winghaven is trying to clean up the top here, and he's getting some good work done, enough to distract them while Unfixed cleans up Crew as well.
Shay's right now getting into back as Genji, building up his ult, already at 63%. Good job coming from his Unfixed, piling on his Reaper, getting so much Reaper value, about to get a triple kill here if he's able to get Lucio. Lucio running for his life, runs to a friendly Reaper. Unfixed says, okay, I'm not taking Lucio and Reaper at the same time. But doesn't matter, as REUNITED just piles on two extra kills. They're moving forward and they're doing everything they need to do right now against this Misfit squad.
Yeah, absolutely rolling. The double Reaper is not really getting anything done. Crew is going to come in at the very last second here and just skull it out. Soon is still alive on the card, but they're just bleeding kills right now.
Winghaven coming in, gets a double kill. This is looking very good right now for REUNITED. Really, it's been... Misfits has not been able to settle down at all. Big Reflect into Zapri, takes out the Death Blossom. Jade's slicing and dicing, looking for more, gets a double kill. Some good Genji play coming out here as REUNITED gets to this checkpoint. And they don't even need to get to the second checkpoint because their next checkpoint is what wins them the game.
Yeah, they don't even have to get it to the checkpoint. It's just a giant yellow square on the ground they gotta get it to.
The arbitrary yellow square, as some might see it, but that's actually as far as the offensive Misfits was able to go right here. This is the payload target. And things are a little bit rough here if you're a fan of Misfits because Volskaya Industries might be on the table. And look at all the ults are up here for REUNITED. Oh my goodness. They are loaded for bear.
Yeah, they are everything you want except Sound Barrier. They just need to find some way to take this high ground. Defense is in a decent position now with their Pharah and their Mercy already on high ground. Crew's coming around the backside.
Pulse Bomb comes up, but does not quite get the value they want. Winghaven winning the Reinhardt v. Reinhardt deal deep in the back, but speaking in the back, True is able to sneak his way back. Gonna get Earth Shattered instead. Big ult from Winghaven, setting up his team for two extra kills. As REUNITED now, sensing victory. They only need to bring this a little bit further back.
Yeah, really nice res though, and Winghaven's kind of isolated in the back line. He's gonna charge to try to rejoin his team and not get picked off there. He does not, so now that they're just really pushing. Morte goes down though, it's a huge pick.
Is a huge pick on Morte's down. There will be no res here for the offense. Defense badly needed that. But Winghaven again in the back gets another kill. Winghaven has been the destroyer of worlds, just moving in with the left click. Three kills here for REUNITED as they move forward. And Shades could end this with Dragonblade, going to get ended by Crew instead, but look at the payload. It's still moving forward. The defense has to stay on this. If this gets to the point, that is it. The yellow square is on the way. REUNITED going to force a map 5, which is Volskaya.
Volskaya Industries. Well, I like watching it, so as long as I play it, I'm all good with that. It should be cool to watch like the new rule set too. We haven't seen Volskaya in months. Unfortunately for REUNITED, last time we saw it, I think it was them losing to IDDQD in a finals on it. But now a chance for redemption.
This is where Winghaven just had such a game. Had big Earth Shatters, big plays. Really good game here for Winghaven, though. A really good game for REUNITED in general, as pretty much everything went their way.
They seem to really like Route 66. That's something to keep an eye out in future tournaments, because they're definitely favored on it, and they look pretty strong in it. And a lot of teams don't like it. So if they can force teams to play it, they definitely would have an advantage there. But that's all in the past now.
It's all in the past. We are going to Volskaya Industries. Let's do it.
For tournament point.
Using the new time bank system.
All right. You're so happy about Volskaya. It has been a long time since we've seen Control Point, mostly because we had them banned out. They weren't in the map pool. So that was the reason why you didn't see Control Point. Volskaya. So we're just kind of communicating with the players, letting them know the rule sets of what we're using here. If it does end in a tie, rather than going through the kind of replay or draw system, we are going to be running a random King of the Hill map. That's the rules, Gamescom rules. So while ZP communicates with them, I just want to thank everyone for watching here. We definitely appreciate your viewership. Without you guys, we can't have sponsors. Sponsors can't play players, and we don't have games to watch and cast, etc. It's all the circle of life, and you're a crucial part of it. Of course, if you have not donated yet and you would like to donate, our Matcherino page is !Matcherino. Of course, our initial prize pool is furnished by our sponsors, G2A, Rocket, and OWKings.com. we have a coupon code for OWKings. It's GOSU. You get 10% off there. And we do have a new tool if you're looking for Overwatch players, pf.gg, to find people who like to party. My name's Rod, and I like to party.
Alrighty, well, there you have it. Well, we are going to get into game here in just a moment. Volskaya Industries will decide it all. How is it always REUNITED that's playing when this happens? I feel like it's always reunited when we get the weird map to end a series.
Yeah, I mean, there's two things. I think odd is just circumstances. You know, just an oddity, one of those strange coincidences that happens. And also, reunited's always in the finals. So, like, they're always playing, and they're always in semis and finals. So the odds that it would happen to them are much higher than most other teams. I don't think anyone plays as many tournaments as reunited.
Now, Reunited, they've been in everything for a really long time. One of the grindiest teams in the game. Mm-hmm. There was a point where they're playing in every EU and NA weekly. They've dodged out of the NA weeklies in recent times just because of the fact that it is actually pretty hard to do cross-continental at points. The ping is a bigger deal than it used to be in the past due to the recent netcode changes, so you don't see quite as much of them on NA shores, but they still play in pretty much everything EU-related.
Yeah, so we're ready. We're just waiting to begin. I hope we don't need another break. It's been a weird day as far as just maps and breaks and things like that. So hopefully we just jump right into it. Let's go ahead and Volskaya. And I think most of us are praying it doesn't go to King of the Hill.
Yeah, because if both teams tie here, it will in fact go to King of the Hill. It will be back. The cavalry will arrive. And it'll be a full best out of five as well. So technically, this is probably the last map. But it might not be the last map.
Oh, don't jinx us. Okay.
It'll be okay, Hex. It'll be okay.
Yeah. So, Crew is saying that they're ready. That is half of the equation. Misfits are ready. We're waiting for Reunited to confirm that they're ready. And then for Morte to hit start.
Oh, man. Chat just giving you the ha-ha treatment and the my name is Rod and I like to party. Yeah, you don't get anything past Twitch chat, Hex. That's why, when in doubt, if you do say a cringeworthy statement, follow up with SM Orc.
It's
awaken the SM Orc legion of fans in chat. They will move in. I mean, you're a hunter in Hearthstone anyways. You should be doing that to begin with. Go for the face,
It's
Hex.
A movie reference, so plus one of the people who got the movie reference. It's a great movie, too. My name's Rod, and I like to party. It's from Hot Rod, man.
Right, well,
you've never seen Hot Rod?
Hopefully, we'll be in game soon. And no, I haven't.
Oh, do you like the Lonely Island guys from SNL? Andy Samberg?
It's their first. I've seen them. I mean, I don't watch that much SNL either.
It's their first movie. Yeah, it's really good. Gotcha. It's really funny. Danny McBride's in it. If you like him, he plays Danny McBride as he always does.
This is one of those things where I'll be like, I'll probably see the movie at some point and then never see the movie.
Okay.
That's just where I'm at. It's like I'll note it. For future reference, and then never actually touch it.
Okay.
As we are waiting here for Morte. Morte probably using the bathroom yet again, given how Reunited has been here today. The bathroom is the absolute destroyer of downtime.
Yep.
Hopefully we'll be here in here.
I mean,
we're just
building the tension for Volskaya.
Volskaya.
You think we see double Winston here? It's really good to initiate on Volskaya.
We've seen double Winston everywhere.
Yeah.
But yes, double Winston definitely was a thing on Volskaya. All right, guys, so again, we are just waiting for Morte to come back in.
Maybe
I'm going to say Morte arise to help things out here. I'm sure someone is in the bathroom. I'm not sure who. We work with what we are given with, though.
Yep. I love chat. Say it's a mix of ha-has.
See, SM Orcs are outdoing the ha-has right now.
Everyone loves this.
The SM Orc army is stronger. We will never be slaves. Crew saying 1 second. So again, we're waiting for Reunited.
And for what is supposed to be our last match of the day. It has been, 8 hours now? 9 hours? Something like that?
Something like that.
Traveling to Volskaya Industries.
All right, so we are finally getting into Volskaya Industries. The dream is real, or the nightmare, depending on your point of view. But it will be the map that decides it all. 2CP back in the house using the brand new nifty time bank system put in by this patch.
All right, it's been a while since we've casted on Volskaya, so I don't really know what to expect. I could see absolutely anything here. What is actually important, though, is that you're going to see Winghaven play the Symmetra. The walk to first is absolutely brutal. You cannot make it alone, so you need the teleporter. It's all going to hinge on him getting that tele up early.
This is one thing we haven't seen, and actually I'm surprised we didn't see it on King's Row. We didn't see 6 Hanzos, but we will see 4 Lucios helping Winghaven make his journey.
Gotta go fast.
Amp it up, let's go.
Gotta go fast. Ooh, you hear that? So Winghaven, you know, it's a lot on him on this first point defense, being able to get the teleporter up, so he's going to be looking for orbs. Conversely, they're going to try to get some flankers in there, knowing that teleporter is going to go down. It actually might be Crew on D.Va, who is on teleporter hunting duty. So definitely this Metra is important.
We might end up with no Lucios at all. In fact, we went from all Lucio to no Lucio. Sad times, Lucio not always used on the defense anymore. But looking at the full defense as it's up, it's going to be Winghaven on the Symmetra, Shades on Roadhog, Cruz on 76, Morta and Mercy, Volataja on defensive Vicari, and Unfix going to be on the defensive Tracer.
Yeah, offensively, there looks like they're running double 76. That's Soon and Zapre. Navix will be on Mercy, Skipjack on Reinhardt. Crew is going to rock onto Zarya, and then Zebo will play Lucio. So a pretty standard composition coming out, except for the double soldiers, which is something we also have seen on Volskaya. They really just like taking a long angle. They're going to be peppering this top right corner.
Yeah, if they can get the high ground, they're going to have all they need and more to actually give this to the defense here. They're going to be behind the Reinhardt. They'll have double the poke from the soldiers. I like what they're doing here, and that they're not going to run into anything Symmetra-related.
Yeah, they are eating some orbs, but now that's kind of off the table as well. Skipjack gets a really nice kill on Volataja. That's so much of the damage.
Gets a double kill. Skipjack in the house right now makes it a double. One off the fire strike, one off the hammer. And this is pretty bad here for REUNITED. They're giving up point A in record time.
Yeah, Winghaven's not going to be able to get this telly up really anytime soon. Is that 89? If they keep eating orbs, Winghaven goes down.
The big charge coming from Skipjack. Down goes Shades. Rez not even on the table as Morte just gets lasered down. What a quick cap, and they're going to be able to move right into point B.
This is how you want to win on these maps, too. Just use all the momentum you have from first. You don't want to let defense get set up ever.
They're already on the point. This could be very quick. Two capture here coming out from side Misfits. They already have the tech visor coming out from Soon. And they're going to have another tech visor right after from Zapri. So the firepower coming up from Misfits right now is huge. Another tech visor coming out. They are just making this look easy. Morte does come in with the res. Is the last ditch res. Two Reavers coming back into the fray. One is Volataja, one is Cruz, but they're both going down. Soundbearer out now from the offensive Misfits, and oh my goodness, this has been all momentum on their side.
Yeah, they're cleaning up right now. It has been all of them in the kill feed. They have two ticks. Here comes Morte and the Desperation D.Va. D.Va Desperation, definitely a thing. Too late, though.
8:18 left on the time bank. What a time being set here from the side of Misfits.
Score 0-2.
Real fast.
Switching sides.
I mean, when you run a Symmetra and you don't get a teleporter down, that's what happens. He was so close, he had 100%, but then they killed him in the backside, so just brutal there. I said it was going to be dependent on Winghaven. It always is with a Symmetra. He got some good damage done, was so close to it, but was unable to stay alive and drop it.
Alrighty, so defense now going to be setting up here for the side of Misfits instead. REUNITED will be on the attack. Both teams, of course, maintain their color, so it's still going to be red versus blue. And looking here at the defense as it rolls out here for the side of Misfits, it is going to be Soon on the Reaper, Zapri and Crew on a pair of 76s, Nevix on the Mercy, Zebosai on Torbjorn, so Aardvark potentially going to pay off, and Skipjack going to be rounding things out here on the Reinhardt.
Okay, well, for the REUNITED offense, Unfix is going to be on that 76. Morte, for the moment, is on Hanzo, but I don't think that's going to stick. Volataja is on Tracer, Shades on the Genji, Winghaven on Winston, and, Cruz on Lucio. So, we'll see. Morte was, he's back on the Zenyatta. I don't know if this is for real or not, but we can hope. It would be the first Zenyatta sighting of the season.
I think it's going to be Mercy, but you never know. Maybe Morte is saying, look, in our darkest hours, Zenyatta will light the way. Morte, please, don't play with our hearts like this. We haven't seen Zenyatta all day. We haven't seen Zenyatta in basically weeks.
That's true.
Not counting FaZe.
What, FaZe doesn't count? Never mind.
Not after what they did, Josh OG.
That's fair.
And wait, he's coming out of Zenyatta. It's happening! All right, I am entirely invested for REUNITED right now. The Zenyatta dream, will it be real?
Well, they're going to have to do something to crack this top here. They have a Tracer in the backline, so he's going to be in here just annoying. That's going to be Volataja. All you're really trying to do is get them to drop shields and divide their attention here. They're going to wait, and the Unfix is going to try to come out.
Zenyatta coming in does immediately get the Discord Orb. Three quick kills coming out for REUNITED. Make it four. The Zenyatta dream is real. And they're going to be saying just as quick of a time here in point A. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that's one way to win a fight. So some switches come up immediately from Misfits. Soon and Zapray are gonna go to double Reaper. Nevix is on Mercy. They're adding a triple Reaper here? Maybe? I guess they see
The Reapers are coming in. Crew, though, will be swapping to the Pharah.
Okay. Defensive Pharah is actually really good on this map.
The one upside here for the defense, that the defense was able to reestablish here. They're not going to get rolled through quite as quickly, although ultimate advantage definitely is with Reunited. We'll just have to see how this works out as they are getting back here on top point. Look at Voltage now, creeping to the back line, looking for this Pulse Bomb pickup. Oh, not like this. Mercy just goes down. He walks up the Mercy, lands a stick. Reunited getting right into it. Are they going to cap this out even faster? Is that going to be a thing right now? Morte certainly thinks so. Morte able to get the kill on Zenyatta. Is Zenyatta going to win a map? This is happening.
Yeah, I'm just
Zenyatta is being played, and they are setting a quicker time.
I'm just absolutely stunned by it. This Zen play, the Discord orb is absolutely lighting people up. He's got Transcendence now, so they're going to be completely safe.
Zenyatta is no longer on the milk carton. Reunited right now with the Sound Bearer, keeping all control here on the point, getting everything they wanted more. D.Va is able to get back to her mech, but the mech just immediately goes down. All kills in the world going forward. And here's a little bit of Transcendence for your mental health coming in from Reunited. And Reunited, it's not a faster time, but it was close.
Yeah, that's, I was glad to see Zen back. I didn't even know what that hero looks like anymore, and he played it really well. They absolutely crushed that first point, and now, I guess this, we're just gonna keep going until our time.
All right, 2-2, we're gonna keep going. This is where the time bank system is pretty good. So, assembling your heroes yet again, the defense will be out for Reunited, the offense for Misfits, and we'll have to see where it goes.
All right, so I imagine they try to run similar things that they've already run, or they completely switch it up because they didn't work very well. But you'd think that they're still going to try to run this Symmetra, as if you can get it up, it will work really well. It's just a matter of if they can. And in fact, they actually do switch off of the Sim. I guess they're just going for Resurrection instead. So that is on the defense for Reunited. Cruz is going to play a Torb instead. Morte will be on Mercy. Valtaja on Steady Old McCree. Winghaven on Reinhardt. Shades on Genji. Unfixed on Tracer.
Aardvark Dream is dead. Cruz actually going to 76 in the end.
Okay, so a lot of damage coming out here. Single tank, single support.
Well, take a look here at the offense. It's going to be coming out here from the side of Misfits. It is going to be Zapri on a 76, soon on a second 76, Skipjack on Reinhardt, Crew on Zarya, Zebosai and Lucio and Nevix on Mercy. And if I'm Reunited here, I actually try and lock down the other side. You saw them all come in from this right side from the defense's perspective, left side from the offense. They just need to go right here where the camera is right now and hold this, not hold back where they are. Because this is what really let them set up last time, is that they went in through the left side and just went up here and were able to get all sorts of 76 poke in.
Yeah, I mean, that's actually why Cruz is hanging out up there. They know what the strategy is. They're going to move over there immediately. They don't want to just fight from the low ground. They'd like to be on even platforms here and just get damage across.
Well, same offensive setup coming in here from Misfits, but they are going to be going against a double 76 here, which will make it a little bit more difficult as both teams struggle here for positioning. They're just going to drop down on the point, though. They're going to make Reunited come to them again, and this is what happened on the last time we saw this. Both sides, though, still at full HP. No side losing anything just yet. Crew, though, first pick. We'll take out Crew. 65 now. They're Misfits. Make it a 6v4. And, oh my goodness, is this happening again? All kills going in favor of Misfits right now. They're doing whatever they want to Reunite. Down goes Shades. And Hex, this might be deja vu all over again.
Yeah, Morte only 3% away from the Resurrection as he dies on that point. They're going to have res up for offense as well. Not as many offensive ultimates up this time, although now we do see a defensive Mei coming into the mix.
They're getting right in on top of the point, and yeah, maybe Shade's going defensive Mei, but is that going to be enough here? I mean, again, it's going to stall out a little bit, but Mei just going to go down in style, crew with the double kill. I've got you in my sight. And once again, we see all sorts of death chaining coming in from the offensive Misfits, doing whatever they want to Reunited. Big routes on surges up, pulls in two. And again, is this going to be over before it begins? Even with the Morte res, not going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, these tactical visors are going down. That's going to be able to clean up. Mei is delaying a little bit on the point. She gets cleaned up as well. Now it's Tracer's
time. What a strong offense coming out here from Misfits, and All right, Reunited, might be your call here as you're going to have to go back on the offense yet again.
Well, here come the Divas, a little late yet again.
Complete.
All right, so 4-2 in favor of Misfits. We're going to swap sides again on Volskaya, which, by the way, as long as it doesn't end in a tie, will be our final map.
Yeah, stop bringing up ties. It's going to be your final map.
Dude, the tie could happen. We could be going to King of the Hill yet. X, embrace it.
No. So, yeah, I mean, defenses are not having any luck on this map at all, which is kind of strange because we've seen this map get locked down and competitive on defense before, but it is seeming to be a more aggressive, just kind of where Overwatch is
right
now.
Broken the map.
Yeah.
I figured out how to get underneath and away from the map. There's invisible walls there, but if you go through the water, you go up this way. This is the new cameraman tech. We have broken everything, people. No one can stop us from visiting our Mr. Destructoid overlords. Oh my god, it's coming for the camera! Retreat! Anyways, going back to the defense here, coming out from the side of Misfits is going to be Skipjack on the Roadhog, Green, Crew on the Pharah, Nevix on Mercy, Soon on the 76, Zebosai on Torbjorn, and Zapri going to be on the Roadhog. So once again, they're going to hope that Aardvark pays off against this offensive Reunited.
Well, the offensive Reunited is running the Zenyatta again. Morte is on that Zen. Winghaven is on, you know, they're running double Winston as well. That's on Unfixed and Winghaven. And Valotage is going to play Tracer. Right. Cruz on Lucio. Shades on his best hero, probably in Genji. He seems to default to it when they just doing whatever they want.
Yeah, why not? Throw Shades in the Genji. He does have a pretty good Genji. Hasn't had the greatest moments, but has had a few areas where he's gotten a few double or triple kills here tonight, so it's been half and half for Shades, but here we go, offense is on the way. Reunited now looking to even up the score here in Volskaya. 8 minutes left in their time bank. Here we go. So early poke coming out here, turret will go down from Shades' poke. Not feeling too much in the way of ult here just yet, but a big hook coming in here from Skipjack, takes out Cruz, and this is a much better defense so far from the side of Misfits. Actually, the first time I've seen a defense do anything here in this map, really.
Yeah, they're actually on the kill feed, which means it's the best defense we've seen so far. Morte is still very far behind, he's gonna try to stay safe. He eats a Helix from Soon!
Ooh, that was brutal. And yeah, defense not getting run over, feels good, man.
I mean, that Helix, though. Yeah, Zenyatta's pretty squishy, but Helix rockets from the distance. He just kept poking, playing with fire. There was no reason for him to be out there. He wasn't going to get anything done, then absolutely punished for it.
Alrighty, so the offense Reunited regrouping after getting wiped out there. Voltage is taking out the turret again. Bad day for Aardvark. Bad day to be a Torbjorn turret. But Reunited now taking the approach that we saw Misfits take time and time again.
He's really close to getting this Molten Core up, which is absolutely devastating on defense.
Crew, though, able to take out Voltage immediately here. Winghaven, though, getting into the fight really back and forth from both sides. And Shade does have a Dragon Blade on the ready. Going to use it, looking to slice out Morte. Not able to do it in time, getting just kited around. Has to deflect in the end. And will go down, so not able to get on to Nevix in the end. Nevix going to live. A very close fight here, but it looks like the defense is going to hold in here, so Misfits looking much better on their second defensive push here.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really nice hold. He dropped a Molten Core without a turret because he just needed the damage and the health to get it done. He was able to clean up a couple of the heroes on the point. I mean, so much so that this sentry's been a problem for them just because it's just relying on so much of their focus. I mean, Winghaven had to charge it down one of them, then they're just having to fire it. It's just constantly a nuisance.
New attack visor at the right here for Voltage. Does have to deal with the Winston. Winston will not get the kill just yet. The offensive Reunited trying to take this high ground, being challenged every step of the way. Everyone has everyone in their sights. Attack visor coming out from offense and defense both at the same time. Voltage are going to get the better of that. Will take out soon. And this is looking for good for Reunited. If they can get one or two more kills, it's going to be huge. However, Nevix is still alive. He does have a res up. Down to 49 HP. He's just going to use the res early. Only reses up one. We'll see if it's worth enough as Skipjack going to go down. Reunited now really starting to make this point their own.
Yeah, they're cleaning up the hut. That should be their point. There's not going to be any reinforcements here. I mean, there's going to be a try to stall out, I guess. Here comes the Primal Rage.
This is where Winston will usually jump into the air repeatedly just to buy a little bit of time. He can jump every 2 seconds. That's exactly what he's doing. However, he will get gunned down. Please call PETA as Reunited now going to take this point. We'll see if they can keep the momentum going on to point B.
Okay, so some switch-ups here. They're running a Junkrat now on defense. They are running two soldiers still on that defense, so it's so many soldiers on the field. We're nearly all soldiers now.
Four soldiers between both teams. Definitely a lot of soldiers in play. But the defense was able to set up here, which we haven't seen all map long, really, as the defense has just gotten rolled over on first and then gets rolled over on second. But defense for Misfits able to reestablish here, and it's going to be a little bit more difficult here for REUNITED. I think they're going to need to get some value tech visors and a value Dragon Blade if they want to turn this in their favor.
Well, I mean, they definitely have the huge ult advantage, and there's not a whole lot of, utility to stop it. There's no sound barrier, there's no May to really stop the attack visor.
All right, so they're speeding in. Here comes Dragonblade. Shade's able to get one kill, making it two, takes out both 76s. The res will undo that work, but that does mean he burned the res relatively quickly here, as REUNITED now moving in. Attack visor at the ready, trying to mow this down. They have almost taken out everyone on the defense.
Yeah.
So REUNITED looking pretty good here, and they should be able to even up the score 4-4.
Yeah, Resurrection came in pretty late there as well for REUNITED, which was good for them. Morte got it just near the end, brings all six up. They are going to kind of come in and stall. Here comes a Genji onto the board.
Oh my goodness, Nevix just got domed by that rocket to the face. They are coming in the Divas. They will be stalling this out just a little bit. Oh my goodness, it's not one, not two. Three Divas are in force. The Mecha forces here. Wing, even though it doesn't care, swings the hammer, picks up a double kill. Wingaven just being absolutely unleashed. Hammer beating gigantic Godzilla killing mech. Complete.
Yeah. You know, who needs technology when you have hammers, right? Score. Although the hammer does have a rocket inside of it. Four. Switching sides. It was the best look for the defense we've seen so far. Definitely on first point as well. I'm actually kind of surprised how offensively favored this has been so far. I was expecting more of a defensive slugfest, but that's just the way of Overwatch right now. It's just the offenses are ruling the day.
I'm not too surprised. Given we saw Volskaya in the past, we would see times of like 2 minutes in the past. Not every single map, but certainly more often than not. So the C team's trading off here blow for blow. Not too surprising, but for the side of Misfits, things are looking good. They do have a 627 time bank compared to REUNITED only having 334. So effectively, they've opened up about a 3 minute lead here. So if they're able to cap this in good time, REUNITED is really going to be on the ropes.
Yeah, so we'll see what they want to bust out here, offensively and defensively. It looks like soldiers are the preferred preferred hero on this map. Is there's going to be two for each side yet again. I wonder if Morte is going to stay on this defensive Zen this time. He ran it on offense. He's definitely running it on defense.
I mean, it worked on offense. Why not bring it out on defense? And Morte, he's well out of the spawn. So looking at this defense as it rolls out here for REUNITED, it's going to be Wingaven on the Reinhardt, Valataja on Tracer, Shades on Roadhog, Morte on the Legends, and Yada himself backed up by 276s played by Cruz and Unfixed.
I mean, it's really risky because there's no resurrection mechanic, no teleporter here, so any death is going to be a permanent one. So offensively, they are running a Mercy. That's Nevix. Zebo's going to be on Lucio, two supports. Skipjack and crew will be the tanks, and Reinhardt and Zarya, and then a couple soldiers, and Soon and Zavre.
So again, Misfits not changing their plan of attack. They're just moving to the left, getting to the high ground. They've done this every single time. I'm really surprised REUNITED has not done anything in advance, just grabbing the opposite side, anything. Because what's going to happen is that they're going to go in here, and then they're just going to drop down on the point and start the cap. And REUNITED getting pushed back. They don't have a good answer to this right now.
Yeah, Tracer's behind, trying to be annoying as Valataja back there. They tried to hit a hook as they ran through, but I absolutely missed that hook, too.
The Valataja getting in deep here on the point, looking for a pickoff, if he can get it. Zapri, though, War Misfits able to get a kill. So is Soon and Skipjack. The offense starting to get value here. REUNITED starting to fall. And might be effectively a repeat of what we've seen before. The only difference, though, is that Valataja is able to get some picks here on the defense, is able to hang in there. But overall, all the momentum in the world is in favor of Misfits. Yet again, REUNITED not able to crack out or figure out the puzzle as to how to defend this first point.
No, absolutely everything going in the favor of Misfits, and I think you're seeing the soldiers here not only because of the damage and attack visors, but this sprint, because they want to be able to go to second point as quickly as possible. Zebo's going to have sound barrier too, which should be the next thing they're waiting for, about 3% away.
They're moving forward. They still have a big time bank advantage as they move forward. They're speeding up. They're moving in, and here they go. Attack visor coming out here from Soon in the back. And if they can get one or two picks here, this could be it here for REUNITED. REUNITED not in any good shape, but in comes a Transcendence from Zenyatta. Will keep his team up and alive. Will he be able to kill Zapri? No, Zapri kills him, but not without almost dying in the process. Still, no three kills here coming up from Misfits. Make it four. The soldiers doing all sorts of work, gunning people down. And this is looking very, very good right now for the side of Misfits. They are getting control of the point. And even though Unfixed pops attack visor, doesn't have a whole lot of targets here. Zapri just going to take him out with the health advantage.
Yeah, here come divas.
Here come the divas. Three divas in play.
So they're trying to sell out, measuring the desperation in divas. They are three desperations deep.
They just want to try and even out the time here, burn off some of the time bank remaining here for the side of Misfits, because Misfits has a huge time advantage right now.
Yeah, doing their best to stall. Here comes the sound barrier as well. Should be able to lock out this point. Unfix is actually going to be in here on the Tracer as well.
Oh, this is where they're just trying to stall out. They're really just trying to burn out this time bank. They're not even trying to remove them from the point. They just want to keep being methodical, burn as much time off as possible. Gonna be difficult though. The Graviton will hold them back, and there it is. Another successful attack coming out from Misfits. 349 remaining in their time bank, 334 remaining in the Reunited time bank. But for Reunited, they're down 2 points, so really, it's a big advantage right now to Misfits.
Yeah, they've just looked a little bit better across this map. I'm agreeing with you that I'm surprised they've done nothing to change up their defense, as Misfits have attacked the exact same way every time, and it seems to have just had no answer. It's no idea on what to
really,
do.
Really? Like, I'm looking at the camera now so people can see. I don't understand why Reunited doesn't hold here, because Misfits, every single time, they keep coming up this direction. You can deny this. You can go over here and make them go up the other way, which might not be as much to their advantage.
Yeah, I mean, just always make a team do something they don't want to do, obviously. If you don't think that they have a secondary strategy, then you just take away the first one and see what happens. So I don't know why they have not adjusted there, but it seems to have not worked out. And, you know, Misfits has just looked very good. And I don't know, it's a strange map, but I'm just kind of surprised at Reunited's reluctance to be able to adjust to what they're seeing.
Well, right now, Misfits has no reason not to do the Overwatch equivalent of continually go for the face, go for that same high ground point, make them stop you, if nothing else. It's what SM Work would approve of. But take a look here at the defense rolling out here for the side of Misfits, a defense that wants to buy 3 minutes and 34 seconds, because if they do that, they'll just win outright. They'll have the 2-point advantage, that'll be it. It is going to be Nevix here on the Mercy, Zapri on the Roadhog, Skipjack on Winston, Crew on defensive Zarya, Soon on Reaper, and Zebosai going to be on Lucio. So no defensive 76 is coming out here from Misfits.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting. Offensively, they are running 276s, and Morte is still on the Zenyatta. No resurrection mechanic available. We can solve any
problem. Oh, look at this defensive position coming out here. They're actually stopping them from going up this flank. This is what I want Reunited to do. Zapri with two quick kills here. Skipjack getting an extra. They stopped that approach, the approach that they used multiple times, and Reunited going to have to try a different door.
Yeah, really smart right there. I think they were just completely unprepared for the defense to be holding there.
No, and again, that's why I don't understand why they didn't try that, why Reunited didn't try that themselves, given what was going on the first two attacks. But either way, Reunited going to have to move forward. More time burned off their time clock. And now there's no 76s after having all 76s. I don't even know what reality is anymore, Axe.
Well, they're taking a page out of the book here, and there are now top. It looks like the Demon's going to collapse on them from both sides, though. Skipjack comes in over the top. The charging Reinhardt will move people out of the way, but he's now super out of position, although Skipjack is taken out by Shades early.
Two quick kills here from the defense as they move forward.
Should res that.
A little bit of Franker Z in the background. I apologize. I don't know what's going on. Yeah. But things working out here for both sides. They're both getting into it on the point. Get back!
Morte
just fighting for this high ground right now, and this is a good defense coming out from Misfits. They're buying all sorts of time. They're bringing it right to Reunited. Soon is able to take out Shades, moves it back, will he be able to get the second kill, looking for an affix, forces out the Wraith form. Oh no, Morte about to go down, eats the elbow, is able to get away due to that Lucio boot. Death Blossom comes out late from Soon, not the value he's looking for, and good stuff on Morte to actually escape there.
Morte should not have lived through that. Even early on, before he got his first resurrection, he was so low, he's getting chased by Winston, was 3% away, was down to about 10 health. They were unable to finish that kill, he brought the res up, they were unable to finish the kill the second time, so just kind of a bit of a mistake not being able to finish off Morte. I think had they done that, they'd be in a great position right now on defense. As it stands, 90 seconds left to push last point. Bastion's on the field.
They're moving forward, and they're keeping all sorts of momentum in their wake.
So where is...
Things looking pretty good for them right now as far as the defense goes. I mean, even though the offense moved forward, the defense was able to reset up. They're in a good position.
Yeah, and they're going to have to deal with this Bastion. Luckily for Reunited, they have all sorts of ultimates to work with. They're going to try to get Windhaven into a good position here.
Big sound barrier coming out here from the side of Reunited. Reunited trying to put this away. Zapri coming in.
Yes,
two kills here for the offense. Or sorry, 2 kills 3 defense. Defense able to hold in here. And El Presidente doing work. Will El Presidente be what puts Misfits over the top? Maybe. The Resurrection is going to bring him back into the fray.
Yeah, Shades is back in on him now. The big big Earthshatter comes down. There's nearly no follow-up, though, as it's only Shades alive on the point. Soon is still alive and being annoying on this Bastion.
Is good stuff coming out here from the side of the defense, and now only 30 seconds remaining.
Yeah, last push. It's go time for Reunited. They have to get it here. Volataja has his attack visor up. God, it's such a long walk, though.
It is a long walk, but this is potentially tournament point here coming out from the side of Misfits. They have Reunited right where they want them, and even if they cap, they're going to get a final attack, so everything looking good for them. Reunited, all their cards here on the line. They need to do something right now or it is going to be over, but take a look at El Presidente. Bash himself does have tank form at the ready. Here comes the tank. Beep boop on the way. Mr. Destructoid would be proud. Takes out Voltaja. One-shots him from afar. Zapri falling through. Misfits in prime position. 3 kills to their name. 4 kills. Morte goes down. And that is GG. The winners here of your weekly will be Misfits, winning it in a very tense series over Reunited. 3-2, would not have it any other way, and what a series here on Volskaya.
Yeah, Misfits has looked great. I mean, they've looked great ever since their Graviton Surge and Pulse 11. They've always been on the rise, so to beat a team like Reunited, who is still in that conversation as the best team in EU in such a fashion, they looked really good, and they look good on pretty much every single game mode. They've got a lot of different compositions, a lot of talented players on the team. Good for them with a signature win in our EU weekly. I mean, Reunited is maybe not the Reunited of old, but that doesn't matter. It's still a win against Reunited in your column.
Alrighty, so that is it. That is going to be your final match of the day. And Hex, it was a good one.
It was a long day. Interesting rule sets. We're trying out some new stuff. We might adjust. Be back tomorrow for North America. That's what I have to say.
And X, there will be no interview today, so any final sellout shoutouts, anything you want to say before we take off for the day?
On Twitter, I'm at Hexagrams, and on twitch.tv, it's /Hexagrams. Pretty easy to find.
Alrighty, well, for me, if you want to follow me at twitch.tv, I will be getting back in the streaming sooner rather than later. And Twitter, at TempoZP, following your favorite casters on Twitter is a great way of showing support. Throw a follow to Hex as well, at Hexagrams. But we'll see you guys tomorrow for the GosuGamers Overwatch Weekly NA Cup, where some of the best teams in NA will be playing. Should be a good one. Until then, we'll see you guys next time.